we are in the presence of God to worship the Lord. We have been, blessing the name of the Lord. We have been praising the name of the Lord. And again, I would like to read one Psalm from Bible, that is Psalm number 111. Especially our guest speaker of today, Dr. Sean O'Neill, also have joined with us in this worship. We are so glad that you are with us, Pastor. God bless you. And we are going to read Psalm number 111. Psalm number 111. We will read that psalm together. And I would like to speak a few words from the psalm. Then after the psalm's exhortation, the time will be given for Sunday school kids for their memory verses. Then after that, there will be a time for testimony and praise report also. Then after that only, Pastor and Dr. Sean O'Neill will be giving the heavenly message towards us this morning. So let us all concentrate and read that Psalm number 111 together. It says like this: Praise the Lord. I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart, in the company of the upright and in the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord. They are studied by all who delight in them. Splendid and majestic is his work, and his righteousness endures forever. He has made his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and compassionate. He has given food to those who fear him. He will remember his covenant forever. He has made known to his people the power of his works, in giving them the heritage of the nations. In works of his hands are truth and justice. All his precepts are sure. They are upheld forever and ever. They are performed in truth and uprightness. He has sent redemption to his people. He has ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all those who do his commandments. His praise endures forever and ever. Praise God. Hallelujah. So Psalm number 111 is a wonderful psalm which speaks about why we praise God. And this is a psalm of a description of God's work in the history of Israel. You know, we have to think about when God has given all the blessings upon the people of Israel. During the time when they were in Egypt, and also during the time when they were traveling from Egypt to Canaan. So this psalm is a description of God's work in the history of Israel. You know, the main four miracles or wonders of God towards Israel is very clearly described here in this psalm. When you go through the verses 9, 5, 6, 7, and 8, we understand there are mainly four miracles and wonders of God towards the people of Israel. That is described in this particular Psalm number 111. Now, when you read verse 9, verse 9 says, He has sent redemption to his people. He has ordained his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. That means verse 9, is the first miracle that God has done for the people of Israel. That is the miracle of redemption of people of Israel from the Egypt. The miracle of redemption of people of Israel from Egypt. Secondly, the second miracle is in verse 5. That is, he has given food to those who fear him. He will remember his covenant forever. That means the second miracle that God has given to them is the miracle of provision of the food in wilderness. Hallelujah. And thirdly, the third miracle is in sixth verse. That is like this: He has made known to his people the power of his works in giving them the heritage of the nations. Amen. The miracle of defeating Canaanites and gave the land of Canaan to Israel. Hallelujah. It's a wonderful thing that God has done for them, defeating the Canaanites and the enemies and gave the land of Canaan to Israel. Hallelujah. And the fourth miracle in this time regarding the people of Israel is in verses 7 and 8. It says like this, the works of his hands are truth and justice. All his precepts are sure. They are upheld forever and ever. They are performed in truth and uprightness. That means the miracle of providing scripture on the Mount of Sinai. Hallelujah. And I believe that that is very clear for every one of us about these four miracles and wonders which God has given to the people of Israel. So remember, the olden memories will lead us to praise the name of the Lord. The olden memories will lead us to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. That's what we understand from the Psalm number 111. The psalmist is, encouraging the people of God to remember the mercy of God, to remember the provision of God, to remember, the protection of God and what God has provided for you. And, worship the Lord in the church. Worship the Lord in the congregation because, God's presence is always with you. Hallelujah. So remember, for a believer, God has provided many material and physical and spiritual blessings and still provides everything. So we have to remember what God has provided for me, the material blessings and the physical blessings and the mental blessings and the spiritual blessings. And we have to remember one thing, still God is providing all the blessings upon the people of God. Hallelujah. So let us praise God for all his material blessings. At the same time, let us compare those material blessings with the spiritual blessings of God, for the Christian believer. Hallelujah. We understand, we have many blessings from God, the material blessings, the worldly blessings. At the same time, we have to compare those blessings of people of Israel to the spiritual blessings that we, the Christian believers, have received. For example, verse 9 says that God rescued the people of Israel from the slavery of Egypt. That's the first one. God rescued the people of Israel from the slavery of Egypt. Likewise, we were once under the bondages and slavery of sin and Satan. Hallelujah. And we were under the bondages of Satan and the sin. But thank God that God rescued us. Thank God for God has rescued us. Hallelujah. And secondly, verse 5 says, God provided the heavenly manna in the wilderness. God provided the heavenly manna for the people of Israel in the wilderness. You know, every morning they received the heavenly food. Hallelujah. They received the heavenly food every morning. And God opened the windows of the heaven. Bible says God opened the windows of the heaven and provided it for 40 years. For 40 years. Isn't that amazing? That God was providing all the blessings upon the people of Israel while they were in the wilderness, while they were traveling through the wilderness. Remember, when these believers are in a journey, through the desert. But thank God for his provision of the daily bread. How many of you are ready to thank God for the daily bread that we are receiving from the Lord? Hallelujah. Every moment of our life. God provided for the people of Israel, lakhs of people. They were, provided by and they were fed by God, in the wilderness. Hallelujah. That is a daily bread. And daily they were receiving the blessings. Hallelujah. So this morning, let us remember, what God has provided for us every day, the daily bread and the livelihood. Hallelujah. And thirdly, verse 6 says that God defeated their enemies and drew the Canaanites out from Canaan and gave the land of Israel for the people of Israel. Hallelujah. Let us thank God for that great work of God. God defeated their enemies and drew the Canaanites out from the Canaan and gave the land for Israel. Hallelujah. So let us thank God for helping us to always fight against the sin and the satanic power and the worldly pleasures. Hallelujah. And we are on the way to the promised land. we are on the way to the promised land. Hallelujah. You know, I mean, God, I mean, arranged the lamb for the people of Israel to redeem from their, I mean, sins, to redeem from their, I mean, bondages of this Egypt. At the same time, God has arranged Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ, I mean, shed his own blood on the cross of Calvary to deliver, to redeem the people of God and to the unto God. Hallelujah. So that's what we understand. I mean, God is the God who is enabling the people of God, I mean, to fight against the enemies. The enemies means fight against the satanic power and the sin and the worldly pleasures. Hallelujah. And fourthly, and we can read that verses 7 and 8. He says that the work of his hands are truth and justice, and all his precepts are sure. That means God provided the laws and scripture on the Mount Sinai. Hallelujah. God provided the laws and the scriptures on the Mount Sinai. Hallelujah. And let us thank God for providing the word of God, the heavenly manna in our spiritual life. Hallelujah. You know, daily, the people of God are blessed with all the spiritual blessings. Hallelujah. God has saved us, and God is giving, heavenly manna, the word of God towards us, every day in our life. Hallelujah. So we are supposed to thank God, for all his benefits upon, our spiritual life. Hallelujah. Giving all the material blessing and also giving all the spiritual blessing upon the people of God. And also, hallelujah, let us thank God for the word of God. Let's thank God for the word of God that we are having. We are eating the word of God as a spiritual food. Hallelujah. So that is the heavenly manna that we are receiving. Even today also, we are going to receive the heavenly manna from the servant of God. Hallelujah. So let us be seated in the presence of God with a heart of prayer and worshiping God. And God is going to bless us together. Hallelujah. And the people of Israel, they were, praising God for the redemption of those people. And the people of Israel, they were, praising God for the food in the wilderness. And the people of God, people of Israel, they were, praising God and worshiping God for defeating the enemies, the Canaanites. And fourthly, the people of God, they were worshiping and praising God for the scripture or the law which was, received from them from God on the Mount Sinai. Hallelujah. So let us also give thanks unto the Lord for all the material and spiritual blessings, and God bless you all.